Dear sir, madam, professor, and all of you, today I am very honored and happy to present my tutorial on expectation maximization EM algorithm, part one. This is the introduction part. I'm Professor Dr. Ngọc Nguyễn, PhD, postdoc from Vietnam. And I'm also the founder of Ngọc Nguyễn's Academic Network. This is my email and my homepage. I'm very honored and happy to contact with you. Now, I begin this presentation. Abstract. Maximum likelihood estimation MLE is a popular method for parameter estimation involve applying and probability and statistics, but MLE cannot solve the problem of incomplete data or hidden data because it is impossible to maximize likelihood function from hidden data. Expectation maximum EM algorithm is a powerful mathematical tool for solving this problem. If there is a relationship between hidden data and observed data, such hidden relationship is specified by a mapping from hidden data or observed data, or by a zone probability between hidden data and observed data. In other words, the relationship helps us know hidden data by surveying observed data. The essential ideology of EM is to maximize the expectation of likelihood function over observed data based on the hidden relationship instead of maximizing directly the likelihood function of hidden data. Pioneer in EM algorithm rule its conversion. As a result, EM algorithm produces parameter estimator as well as MLE does. This tutorial aims to provide explanation of EM algorithm in order to help researchers comprehend it. Moreover, some improvements in of EM algorithm are also proposed in the tutorial, such as combination of EM and truth order conversion, Newton-Raphson process, combination of EM and Rayleigh descent method, and combination of EM and fractal swarm optimization BSO algorithm. Table contains. This report focuses on introduction of EM and related concepts. 1. Basic concept. 2. Parameter estimation. 3. EM algorithm. Basic concept. Literature of expectation maximization EM algorithm in this tutorial is mainly extracted from the preeminent article Maximum Likelihood from Incomplete Data via the EM algorithm by Dempster, Lair, Rubin. For convention, let DLR be referenced to such the author. We begin a review of EM algorithm with some basic concepts. By default, vectors are column vectors. All types of vector can be column vector or row vector. For example, given two vectors X and Y and two matrices A and B. Here, X and Y are both are column vectors. A row vector is represented as follows: Z here. Z0 vector is denoted as 0 here. 0 matrix A denotes A here. Matrix lambda is diagonal if it is square and its element outside the main diagonal are 0 lambda here. Let I be identity matrix or unit matrix here. Vector addition and matrix addition are defined like numerical addition. Here, vector and matrix can be multiplied with scalar k here. Let superscript t denote transposition operator for vector and matrix A follow here. It's where matrix A is symmetric if and only if A t equal A. Transposition operator is linear with addition operator A follow here. Dot product or scalar product of two vectors can be written in transposition operator here. However, the product SYT result out a symmetric matrix I follow here. The length of model of vector S in Euclidean space is here. The notation here also denotes absolute value of scalar or determinant of square matrix. Not determinant is only defined for square matrix. Let A and B be two square NN matrix we have here. If A has a non-zero determinant, then as it inverse denoted A inverse A minus 1 such that here. Where I E identity matrix, if matrix A has its inverse, A is called invertible or non-singular. Let A and B be two invertible matrix we have. Continue. Given invertible matrix A, it is called orthogonal matrix if A minus 1, A inverse equal A to 10 both, which means that here. Of course, orthogonal matrix is symmetric. Product multiplication operator of two matrices A, Mn, and B, Nk, E. Here. Square matrix A is symmetric if A I j equal A j I for all I and j. If A is symmetric, then A tends both equal A. If both A and B are symmetric with the same number of row and column, then they are commutable such that AB equal BA, with not that the product AB and BA produce a symmetric matrix. Given invertible matrix A, if it is symmetric, its inverse A minus 1 is symmetric too, given N matrix AI, such that their product multiplication operator is valid, we have. Given square matrix A, trace A is trace operator with the sum of its diagonal elements. Pay attention to trace operator because it's very popular and important to matrix operator. Given invertible matrix A is n row and n column, Jordan decomposition theorem state that A is always decomposed A follow here. This equation is very important. Where used is orthogonal matrix composed of Asian vector, hence use econ eigenvector matrix here. There are n column eigenvectors ui in U, and they are mutually orthogonal. Uit uj equals 0, where lambda is a diagonal matrix composed of eigenvalue. Hence, lambda is called eigenvalue matrix, where lambda I are eigenvalue when invertible matrix A is decomposed according to Jordan decomposition. We call A is diagonalized. If A can be diagonalized, it is called diagonalizable matrix. Of course, if A is invertible, A is diagonalizable. There are many documents for matrix diagonalizable. For matrix diagonalization. Given two diagonalizable matrices A and B are equal size NN, then they are simultaneously diagonalizable, and hence there exists an orthogonal eigenvector matrix U such that here A equals U gamma UT, B equals U lambda ut, where lambda, gamma, and lambda are eigenvalue matrix of A and B respectively. Given symmetric matrix A, it is positive, negative, definite. If and only if ST AS larger than 0, or ST AS smaller than 0, for all vector S different from zero. It is positive, negative, semi-definite if and only if STAS larger than or equal to zero, or STAS smaller than or equal to zero for all vector S. When diagonalizable AC diagonalized into U lambda UT, it is positive, negative, definite if and only if all eigenvalues in lambda are positive or negative. Similarly, it is positive, negative, semi-definite if and only if all eigenvalues in lambda are non-negative, non-positive. If A is the greater A scalar concept, the concepts positive definite, positive semi-definite, negative definite, and negative semi-definite become concept positive, non-negative, negative, and non-positive respectively. Symbol Fs is the scalar by vector function, for instance, here, when R is an dimensional real vector space. The first order derivative of Fs is the resonant vector A follow, where is a partial first order derivative of S with regard to Si. So, the resonant of is a growth vector. The second order derivative of S is called the Hessian matrix A follow, where it is Hessian matrix and it is the elements. Second order partial derivative of Si are on the diagonal of Hessian matrix here. Diagonal. This is the second order partial derivative of Si. In general, vector calculus is complex subject. Here, we focus on the scalar by vector function with some properties. C, A, B, and M are scalar constant, vector constant, vector constant, and matrix constant respectively. Simple vector and matrix operator are valid, and we have. If M is a square matrix constant, we have. Function Fs is called an order analytic function of an order smooth function if there is the existence and continuity of k order derivative of S, where k equal 1 to k. Function Fs is called smooth enough function if k is large enough. According to Schwarz's theorem, if Fs is second order smooth function, then its Hessian matrix is symmetric here. Given Fs being second order smooth function, Fs is convex, strictly convex in domain S if and only if its Hessian matrix is semi positive definite in S. Similarly, Fs is concave, strictly concave in domain S if and only if its Hessian matrix is semi-negative definite or negative definite in S. Extreme bound, optimizer bound, optimal bound, or optimizer at S star is a minimum bound, minimizer of convex function, and its maximum bound, maximizer of concave function here. Given second order smooth function Fs, has stationary bound S star if its region vector at S star is 0, dFs star equals 0. Thus, believe extension that the notation dFs star is the derivative of Fs at S star equals 0. The stationary bond S star is the local minimum bond if Hessian matrix at S star that is D square FSK is mostly defined. Otherwise, the stationary bond SK is a local minimum bond if Hessian matrix FSK, that is D square FSK, is a negative defined. If a stationary bond SK is not a string bond, it is settled in with D FSK equals 0 and D square FSK equals 0 too. Finding a string bond is the optimization problem. Therefore, if FS is the second order smooth function and its Riemann vector D FS and Hessian matrix D square FS and are both determined, the optimization problem is processed by solving the equation related from setting the Riemann DFS to be 0, DFS to be 0, and then checking if whether the Hessian matrix DFS star is the positive defined or negative defined, where S star is the solution of the equation DFS equals 0. If such equation cannot be solved due to its complexity, there are some popular methods to solve optimization problem, such as Newton-Raphson and Riemann descent. A short description of Newton-Raphson method is necessary because it is helpful to solve the equation DFS equals 0 for optimization problem in practice. Suppose FS is second order smooth function. According to first order Taylor series expansion of DFS at S equals S0, which very small residual we have. Because FS is second order smooth function, this where FS0 is a symmetric matrix according to Schwarz theorem, which implies here. So we have here, we expect that DFS equals 0 so that S is a solution here. This means here. The tilde, the side tilde denote the approximation. Therefore, Newton-Raphson method starts with an arbitrary value of S0 as the solution candidate and then goes through some iterations. Suppose as kth iteration, the current value is Sk and the net value Sk plus 1 is calculated based on the following equation here. This equation is the core of Newton-Raphson method. The value Sk is solution of DFS 0 if DFSK equals 0, which means that Sk plus 1 equals Sk after some iteration. At that time, we have Sk plus 1 equals Sk equals S star is the local optimizer bond, local string bond. So, the combinated condition of Newton-Raphson method is DFSK equals 0. Note that the S star resulted from Newton-Raphson method is the local minimum bond, local maximum bond if FS is the concave function in current domain. Newton-Raphson method computes the second order degravity d square fs, but the Riemann descent method does not. This difference is not significant, but a short description of Riemann descent method is necessary because it is also an important method to solve the optimization problem in case that solving directly the equation dfs equals 0 is too complicated. Question descent method is also iterative method starting with an arbitrary value of x is 0. A solution candidate. Suppose at kth iteration, the net candidate bond sk plus 1 is computed based on the current sk a follow here. The digression decay here is called descending digression, which is the opposite of gradient of s. Hence, we have a decay equal minus d fsk. The variable k is the length of descending digression decay. The variable k is often selected as a minimizer or maximizer of function gt equal fsk at t decay for minimization or maximization, where sk and decay are known at k iteration. Alternately, tk is selected by some advanced conditions such as Bajirai-Bowen condition. After some iteration, bond sk converges to local optimizer s star when dk equals zero. At that time, we have sk minus 1 equals sk equals s star. So, the terminated condition of Newton-Raphson method is dk equals 0, not the s star resulted from reason. The descent method is a local minimum bond, local maximum bond. If fs is a convex function, concave function in current domain. In the case that the optimization problem has some constraints, the Lagrange duality is applied to solve this problem. Given for all the smooth function fs and constraint gi s smaller than or equal to 0, and sj gi s smaller than or equal to 0, and sj s equal 0, the optimization problem is here. A so-called Lagrange function la s lambda mu is established as a sum of s and constraint multiplied by Lagrange multipliers lambda and mu. In case of minimization problem, la is s lambda mu is. In case of maximization problem, la is s lambda mu is here, where all lambda I, not lambda, and mu are called the Lagrange multiplier, and la is a function of s lambda and mu. Thus, optimizing fs with subject to constraint gis smaller than or equal 0 equal to 0 and sj s equal 0 is equivalent to optimize la s lambda mu, which is the reason that this method equals the Lagrange duality. In case of minimization problem, the gradient of la with regard to s is the dla equal here. Please pay attention here. In case of maximization problem, the gradient of la with regard to s is dla equal here. According to KKT condition, a local optimizer bond s star is solution of the following equation system here. The first equation of this system is the most important, dla equals 0. The last equation in the KKT system above is called the complementary slackness here. This is the last equation, it called as the complementary slackness. The main task of KKT rub gum is solve the first equation DLA equals zero. Again, some practical methods such as Newton-Raphson method can be used to solve the equation DLA. Alternately, Raphson descent method can be used to optimize the LA with constraints specified in KKT system here. We need to scheme some essential probabilistic rules such as the additional rule, multiplication rule, total probability rule, and base rule. Now we change the some basic concept of the probability after we survey some basic concept of the analysis. Please pay attention to some concept about the probability. Given two random events or random variables x and y, additional rule and multiplication rule are expressed as follows. Here, where notation here u and inverse u denote the union operator and intersection operator in set theory. The probability B, X, Y is known as the zone probability. The probability B X given Y is called the conditional probability of X given Y here. Conditional probability is based on base rule mentioned later. If X and Y are mutually exclusive, its intersection equals null set, then and the union of X and Y is often denoted as XY, X less Y, and we have X and Y are mutually independent if and only if one of three following conditions is satisfied, one of three. If X and Y are mutually independent, its intersection are often denoted as XY, and we have here BXY equal BX multiplied by PY. Given a complex set of mutually exclusive events S1, S2, Sn such that here the total probability rule is specified as follows. Here, if X and Y are continuous variables, the probability rule is rewritten in integral form as follows. Not B of Y given X and BX are continuous function known as the probability density function mentioned later. A variable X is called random variable if it confirms a probability distribution which is specified by a probability density function BDF. Now we use the abbreviation BDF to denote the probability density function, and it will be used very often. Or a community distribution function CDF, but CDF and BDF have the same meaning and they share interchangeable property. When BDF is the gravity of CDF, in practical statistics, BDF is used more common than CDF is used. When S is discrete, BDF is degraded as the probability of S. Let upper F and F be CDF and BDF repeatedly equation. 1.1 is the definition of CDF and BDF. This is the continuous case. This is the discrete case. In this case, probability at single bond S0 is determined as B, P, S0 equal F, S0. But in continuous case, probability is determined in an interval AB, 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 where AB and S are real. At interval of the BDF in such interval, they are viewed as the interval of the BDF in such interval. It is easy to expand equation 1.1 for multivariate variable when S is vector. Let S be n dimension random vector, its CDF and BDF are redefined as follows according to equation 1.2. It's either continuous case, and this is the discrete case. Marginal BDF of partial variable SI when SI is a component of SE, the integral of FS over on SJ except SI here. Where here the zone BDF of SI and SJ is defined as the integral of FS over on SK except SI and SJ. Where conditional BDF of SI given SJ is defined as follows here. Indeed, conditional BDF implies conditional probability. Given random variable S and its BDF FS, theoretical expectation ES and theoretical variance VS of S are specified by equation 1.3 here. The expectation ES of S is often called theoretical mean. When S is a multivariate vector, ES is mean vector, and VS is covariance matrix, which is always symmetric. When S is a multivariate, ES and VS have the following form here. Therefore, theoretical means and variance of partial variables SI can be determined separately. For instance, if E SI is the theoretical mean of partial variable SI given marginal BDF FSJ here. If V SI SJ is the theoretical covariance of partial variable SI and SJ given zone BDF FSI SJ SI SJ. Not E SI SJ here equal here. Equal V SI SJ S E SI E SJ each V SI on diagonal of VS of theoretical variance of partial variable SI given marginal BDF F SJ SJ here and not we have is SI square equal V SI S is SI square. Given two random variables S and Y along with a zone BDF FSI, theoretical covariance of SI and Y is defined by equation 1.5. If random variable S and Y are mutually independent given the zone BDF FSY, its covariance is 0, VSI equals 0. However, it is not sure that S and Y are mutually independent. If VSI equals 0, not zone, the zone BDF is the BDF having two or more random variables. If S and Y are multivariate vectors, VSY is the theoretical covariance matrix of S and Y given the zone BDF FSY. When S and Y are multivariate, VSY has a following form here. When VSI, YJ is the covariance of SY, SI, and YJ, and we have VSI, YJ equal ESI, YJ minus subtract ESI and ESI multiply is YJ. Not this is a summary, not a summary. Here. The equation is very important. A zero, ES and VS are openly noted as mu and sigma respectively if they are parameter of BDF, not most of BDFs except normal distribution whose parameter are not ES and VS. When S is univariate, uppercase sigma is often denoted as lowercase sigma square if it is parameter of BDF. For example, if S is univariate and follows normal distribution, its BDF is FX here. This is the equation of normal distribution. If S is a multivariate and follow multivariate normal distribution, its BDF is. In this case, parameter mu and sigma has the following form here. Mu, sigma. Mu equal ES and sigma equal VS. If mu I is the theoretical mean of partial variable SI as usual here. If sigma IJ, where E different from J, is the theoretical covariance of partial variable SI and SJ as usual here. Not E, expectation of SI SJ equals sigma IJ at VI VJ. Sigma II on diagonal of sigma uppercase sigma is the theoretical variant of partial variable SI as usual. Sigma II equal sigma I square equal VSI. And not we have this very important equation. Expectation of SI square equal sigma I square at VI square. Let lowercase a and uppercase a be scalar constraints and vector constraints. Respectively, we have this equation. It's either linear combination. Given a set of random variables s, s1, it is the composite of s1, s2, sn, and the scalar constraint ci. We have this equation. Where variant SI, SJ is the covariance of SI and SJ. If on SI are mutually independent, then. Not given the zone BDF F, S1, S2, Sn, two random variables SI and SJ are mutually independent if F, SI, SJ equal FSI multiply FSJ, where FSI, SJ, FSI, and FSJ are defined as of formation integrals of FSI S1, S2, Sn. Therefore, if only one BDF FS is defined, then of course S1, S2, Sn are mutually independent, and moreover, they are identically distributed. If all SIs are identically distributed, which implies that every SI has the same distribution, the same BDF with the same parameter, then we have. If not, if all SIs are identically distributed, every SI can be represented by the same random variable S. If all SI are mutually independent, and identically distributed IID than the location IID is very important, and they are often used in the sampling and two equation are often used into the estimation based on sample. Because the EM algorithm is essential, an advanced version of maximum likelihood estimation MLE method, it is necessary to retry MLE in short simple random variable S confirms a distribution specified by the BDF denoted S given theta with parameter theta. For example, if S is a vector and follow normal distribution, then here this is not normal distribution where mu and sigma are theoretical mean vector and covariance matrix respectively, with not that theta equal mu sigma. The location, this location denotes the determinant of given matrix and location sigma minus 1 denotes inverse of matrix sigma. Not sigma is invertible and symmetric. Parameter of normal distribution is theoretical mean and theoretical variance. Mu equal expectation of S and sigma equal variance of S. But parameters of different distribution can be different from such mean and variance. Anyhow, theoretical mean and theoretical variance can be calculated based on parameter theta. For example, simple S. S is the n-dimension vector, a random vector, follow multinomial distribution of k trials. Its BDF is here. This is the BDF of multinomial distribution, where Sj are integer and theta is the vector of p1, p2, bn in the set of root probability such that sum of all root probability is equal 1. Here, three constraints. Not Sj is the number of trials generating nominal value j. Firstly, the parameter theta does not include theoretical mean expectation of S and theoretical variance variance of S, but ES and VS of multinomial distribution can be calculated based on theta A follow here. Expectation mean of Sj equal KBJ and variance of Sj is equal KBJ multiplied by 1 minus subtract Bj. When random variable S is considered as an observation, a statistic denoted cos is the function of S. For example, cos equals AS SA, where A is the scalar constant A and uppercase A is the vector constant, and OS equals SST are also statistics of S. Statistics OS can be vector by vector function. For example, OS equals SST is a very popular statistics of S. In practice, if S is played by sample S, the sample S includes S1, S2, Sn, including n observations Si, a statistic is now function of Si. For instance, when it is S bar and S defined below are statistics here. S bar S. For multinormal distribution, S bar and S are estimate of theoretical mean mu and theoretical covariance matrix sigma. They are called sample mean and sample variance respectively. If S is special case of uppercase S, when S has the only one observation A, S equals S. Statistics OS is called sufficient statistics if it has all and only information to estimate parameter theta. For example, sufficient statistics of normal BDF is OS equals SST. In fact, parameter theta mu sigma of normal BDF would include theoretical mean mu and theoretical covariance matrix sigma is totally determined based on and only S and SST. There is no redundant information in OS, where S is observation considered as a random variable. I follow here. Mu equals expectation of S, is a theoretical mean, and sigma equals expectation of S minus mu, and S minus mu T. Similarly, given S is the n dimension vector, sufficient statistics of multinomial BDF of k trials is OS S1, S2, Sn due to Bj equal Esj divided by k for on j. Given a sample constant observation, purpose of bond estimation is to estimate unknown parameter theta based on such sample. The result of estimation process is the estimate theta hat as the approximation of unknown theta. Formula to calculate theta hat based on sample equals estimator of theta as a convention. Estimator of theta is denoted theta hat S or theta hat upper S, where S is an observation and S is sample including many observations. Actually, theta S or theta hat S or theta hat upper S is the sample to theta hat, but the notation theta hat S implies that theta is calculated based on observation. For example, given sample S including an observation IID SI, estimator of theoretical mean mu of normal distribution is mu hat equal mu hat S equal S bar is called the sum of all SI divided by N. As usual, estimator of theta is determined based on sufficient statistics, which in turn are function of observation, where observation are considered as random variables. Estimation methods mentioned in this research are MLE, maximum Bott theory, MAP, and EM, in which MAP and EM are variants of MLE. According to a viewpoint of Bayesian statistics, the parameter theta is a random variable and it confirms some distribution. In some research, theta represents a hypothesis. Equation 1.6 specified by Bayes' rule, in which f of theta given C is called real BDF or real distribution of theta, whereas f of theta given S is called posterior BDF, posterior distribution of theta given observation S, not C is the parameter of the real F of theta given C, which is known as a second level parameter. For instance, if the real F of theta given C is a multivariate normal BDF, and we have a C equal mu 0, sigma 0, which are theoretical mean and theoretical covariance matrix of random variable theta. Because C is constant, the real BDF F of theta C can be denoted F theta, the posterior BDF f of theta given s is not c, because c a constant is the f theta given s according to equation 1.6 here. Equation 1.6 it specify the base rule. Its base rule, the BDF f of s given theta is called the likelihood function. Its posterior BDF f of theta given s has the same form of the prior BDF f of theta given c. Such posterior BDF and prior BDF are called conjugate BDFs, conjugate distribution or conjugate probabilities, and f of theta given c is called conjugate real. For the likelihood function, f of s given theta should bear up f of theta given c, and f of s given theta is called conjugate bear. For example, if real BDF f of theta given c is the Bessel distribution, and the likelihood function b of s given theta followed binomial distribution, then posterior BDF f of theta given s is the Bessel distribution, and hence f of theta given c and f of theta given s are conjugate distribution. Certainly, whether posterior BDF and prior BDF are conjugate BDF depends on prior BDF and the likelihood function. This is a special case conjugate where that both real BDF f of theta given c and the likelihood function f of s given theta are multinormal, which results that posterior BDF f of theta given s is multinormal. For example, when s is the n dimension vector random vector s1 s2 and the likelihood function f of s theta is the multinormal a follow, where theta is equal mu sigma, and mu equal is the vector mu 1, mu 2, mu n. Suppose only mu is random variable which follows the multinormal distribution with parameter c equal mu c mu 0 sigma 0, when mu 0 is here, and sigma zero is the theoretical variance covariance matrix. It is also symmetric and invertible. The real BDF f of theta given c is here. This is normal distribution. It's true that the posterior BDF f of theta given s equal f of mu given s distributes normally with theoretical mean m mu and covariance matrix sigma mu a follow here. The sign indicates the robustion, and we call that this is the robustion sign, not that m mu equal here and sigma mu equal here. This is theoretical mean and theoretical variance of posterior BDF f of theta given s. When s is evaluated as an observation, let theta hat is the estimate of theta. It is calculated as a maximizer of posterior BDF f of theta given s. Here data sample s has the only one observation s. In other words, s is a special case of uppercase s here. Theta is a maximizer of the BDF, the posterior BDF f of theta given s, because the real BDF f of theta given c is assumed to be fixed, and the denominator, this integral, is contained with regard to theta, we have theta hat is a maximizer of Obviously, MLA method determine theta hat is a maximizer of the likelihood function f of s given theta with regard to theta when s is the evaluated as the observation. It's interesting that the likelihood function f of s given theta is the BDF of s with parameter theta. For convenience, MLA maximizes the natural logarithm of the likelihood function denoted L theta instead of maximizing the likelihood function according to equation 117, where L theta is the natural logarithm of f of s given theta equal the log likelihood function of theta. Recall that equation 117 implies the optimization problem, not L theta is the function of theta if s is evaluated as the observation. Here, equation 117. Equation 117 is the simple result of MLE for estimating parameter based on observed sample. The notation L theta given s implies that L theta is determined based on s. If the log likelihood function L theta is the first order smooth function, then from equation 117, the estimate theta hat can be solution of the equation related by setting the first order degravity of L theta regarding theta to be 0, dL theta equal 0. If solving such equation is too complex or impossible, some popular method to solve optimization problem are Newton-Raphson, Raison descent, Laurent duality. Not solving equation dL theta equals 0 may be incorrect in some case. For instance, because in theory, theta hat such that dL theta hat equals 0 may be a pseudobound, not a maximizer. For example of MLE, suppose S is the n-dimension random vector follow multi-normal distribution. Then the log likelihood function is L theta is here. When mu and sigma are mean vector and covariance matrix of f of s given theta repeatedly, with not that theta equal mu sigma, from equation 1.7, the estimate theta hat equal mu hat sigma hat is solution of the equation created by setting the first order of L theta regarding mu and sigma to be 0. The first order Maxwell gravity of L theta with respect to mu is here. Setting this Maxwell gravity to be 0, we obtain mu hat equals s. It's very simple, but very important and very interesting. The first order Maxwell gravity of L theta with respect to sigma is here. Due to this equation. And this equation, because the beam mentioned that this equation is very important and it results from some complicated calculation, where trace A is a trace operator with test sum of diagonal element on square matrix. Trace A is the sum of on A I. This implies that. Substitute the estimate mu hat into the first order partial gravity of L theta with respect to sigma. We have. This is a very beautiful equation. The estimate sigma hat is the solution of the equation formed by setting this first partial gravity to be zero matrix. We use this notation as the zero matrix, and we have sigma hat is equal the product of s minus mu hat and s minus mu hat t. Finally, Emery result out the estimated theta hat for normal distribution given observation as a follow here. This result is very important and very popular in the parameter estimation for normal distribution. When we had equal s, then sigma hat equal 0, which implies that the estimate sigma hat of covariance matrix is arbitrary with constraint that it is symmetric and invertible. This is reasonable because the sample is too small with only one observation s. When s is replaced by a sample s, uppercase s, in which all si are mutually independent and identically distributed iid, it is easy to draw the following result by the similar with equation 1.11 mentioned later here. It is easy to prove these two equations. Here, mu hat and sigma hat are sample mean and sample variance. It used to distinguish from the mu and hat are the theoretical mean and theoretical variance. In practice and in general, if S is observed as an unparticled observation at 1, at 2, Sn, let uppercase S be the observed sample of size n in which all Si are id. The basic rules specified by equation 1.6 is rewritten as the follow F theta S here. It is the basic rule. However, the meaning of a rule does not change because on Si iid, the likelihood function become product of partial likelihood function according to equation 1.9. The log likelihood function of theta becomes the equation 1.10. The notation L theta given S implies that L theta is the determined by solution S, and we have equation 1.11. Here, and equation 1.11 is the main result of MLE for estimating parameter based on observation sample. For example, suppose each SI is a vector and follow multinomial distribution of K trials here, where SIK are integer and theta P1 P2, Bn is the set of probability such that this constraint here, constraint 1, constraint 2, and constraint 3. Not xik is the number of trials generating normal value k, given sample s at 1, at 2, at n, in which on si are iid, according to equation 1.10, the likelihood function is, because there is constraint sum up on bj, j from 1 to n equals 0, we use the Lagrange duality method to maximize L theta. The Lagrange function La theta lambda is sum up L theta and the constraint sum up on bj equals 1. I follow here. This is the Lagrange function LA theta lambda. Of course, the Lagrange function LA theta lambda is a function of theta and lambda, where lambda is called Lagrange multiplier. Because a multinomial PDF is smooth enough, the estimate theta hat, B1 hat, B2 hat, Bn hat is a solution of the equation created by setting the first order of LA theta regarding BZ and lambda to be zero. The first order Maxwell's gravity of LA theta with respect to BZ is here. Setting this Maxwell's gravity to be zero, we obtain the following equation. Summing this equation over and the variables BZ, we obtain. Due to two constraints, sum up on BZ equal 1 and sum up Sij over on J equal K. We have lambda equal Kn. Substitute lambda equal Kn into equation here. We obtain the estimate theta hat B1 hat B2 hat Bn hat as follow here. B J hat equal the sum of on Sij over I divided by Kn. Quality of estimation is measured by mean and variance of the estimate theta hat. The mean of theta hat is specified by equation 1 Bontel. The notation theta hat S implies the formulation of to calculate theta hat, which is resulted from MLE, MAP or EM. Hence, theta hat S is considered a function of S in the integrals here, this integral. The theta hat is an unbiased estimate if the expectation E theta hat equal theta. Otherwise, if the expectation E theta hat different from theta, then theta is a biased estimate. As usual, the unbiased estimate is better than biased estimate. The condition expectation E theta hat equal theta is a criterion to check if whether an estimate is unbiased, whether an estimate is unbiased, which is applied to for on estimation method. The variance of theta hat is specified by equation 1 von Tertin here. The smaller the variance V theta hat, the better the theta hat is. There are some situations, some unbiased estimates have larger variance V theta hat than some biased estimate. For example, given multinormal distribution and given sample S, S1, S2, Sn, where all Si are iid, the estimate theta hat is mu hat sigma hat from LE. MLE is here, mu hat sigma hat. And now we check whether mu hat and sigma hat, whether they are unbiased or not. Due to expectation of mu hat e mu hat equal mu, then mu hat is the unbiased estimate. We confirm that mu hat is the unbiased estimate. We also have sigma hat equal sigma subtract V mu hat. It is necessary to calculate the variance V mu hat, and we have V mu hat is either sigma divided by N. Therefore, we have expectation of sigma hat equal N minus 1 divided by N sigma. Hence, we conclude that Sigma hat is a biased estimate because the expectation of sigma hat e sigma hat different from sigma. With the loss of generality, simple parameter theta is vector. The second order derivative of Ngoc-Nyquist function L theta is called Ngoc-Nyquist Hessian matrix according to equation 1.14. Simple theta, theta 1, theta 2, theta r, where there are r, partial parameter theta k. Equation 1.14 is expanded a follow here. The Hessian matrix where the notation S theta given S implies S theta is calculated based on S. If sample S, S1, S2, Sn greater S then here by equation 1.15. This is the Hessian matrix for the sample S. The negative expectation of Nyquist Hessian matrix is called information matrix or Fisher information matrix denoted I theta. Please distinguish information matrix I theta from identity matrix I according to equation 1.16 for defining the information matrix. If S theta is calculated by equation 1.14 with observation S then I theta information matrix is redefined by equation 1.17. The notation I theta given S implies I theta is calculated based on S not D square L theta given S is considered as a function of S in the interval here. If S theta is calculated by equation 1.15 with observation sample S, S1, S2, Sn with on SIID, I theta become defined by equation 1.18. Not D square L theta given S is considered a function of S in the interval. This integral of d square l theta given s over the BDF fs given theta. For MLE method, the inverse of information matrix is called Kramer ground lower bound denoted CR of theta hat according to equation 1.19. Any covariant matrix of MLE estimate theta hat has such Kramer ground lower bound, should Kramer ground lower bound become the variant of theta hat v theta hat if and only if theta hat is unbiased according to equation 1.20. Not equation 1.19 and equation 1.20 are only valid for MLE method. The size greater than or equal to implied lower bound. In other words, ground lower bound is a variant of the optimal MLE estimate. Moreover, besides the criterion expectation of theta hat, e theta hat equal theta, equation 1.20 can be used another criterion to check if whether or not an estimate is unbiased. However, the criterion e expectation of theta hat equal theta is applied for all estimation methods, whereas equation 1.20 is only applied for MLE. Suppose theta, theta 1, theta 2, theta r, where there are partial parameters, the theta k, so the estimate is theta hat equal theta hat 1, theta hat 2, theta hat r. It depends on diagonal of the Kramer ground lower bound is the lower bound of a variance of theta hat k denoted variance of theta hat k v theta hat k. Let CR theta hat k to be lower bound of v theta hat k. Of course, we have equation 1.21 for the criterion to check whether or not Theta Hat case is unbiased. Derived from equation 1.18 and equation 1.19, CR Theta Hat case is specified by equation 1.22 here. This is the equation how to compute the CR the theta hat k, where n is size of the sample s s1 s2 sn in with on SIRID. Of course, I theta hat k is informatics of theta hat k. If theta hat k is univariate, I theta hat k is scalar with equal information value. For example, let S is the set of S1, S2, Sn. B the observed sample of psi n with not that on SIRID. Given multinormal BDF, I follow here. This is the formula of the multinormal BDF, where n is the dimension of vector S and theta equal mu sigma, with not that mu is the theoretical mean vector, and sigma is the theoretical covariance matrix, not sigma is invertible and symmetric. And the notation sigma minus 1 is the denote the inverse of sigma. From reverse sample, the MLE estimate theta hat equal mu hat sigma hat t given SE here. Mu equals SR is the average of all SI, and sigma hat is the estimate of sigma. Mean and variance of mu hat from reverse sample are here. We knew that mu hat is the unbiased estimate with Riterion expectation of mu hat e mu hat equal mu. Now we check again whether or not if mu hat is the unbiased estimate with equation 1.21 with Gramer graph global bound. Hence, we firstly calculate the global bound CR mu hat, and then compare it with the variance v mu hat. In fact, according to equation 1.1a, the Ngoc-Nyquist function is here. Ngoc-Nyquist function of the normal BDF. The Boxer first order the gravity of L theta given s with regard to mu is here. The Boxer second order the gravity of L of theta hat theta given s with regard to mu is here. This is the first order. This is the second order. According to equation 1.22, the global bound CR of mu hat is here. CR mu hat equal the sigma divided by n equal variance of mu hat due to variance of mu hat v mu hat equal CR of mu hat. Mu hat is the unbiased estimate according to the criterion specified by equation 1.21. Mean of sigma hat from reverse example is here. Expectation mean. It means expectation of sigma hat is called n minus 1 divided n sigma. We knew that sigma hat is a biased estimate because expectation of sigma hat is sigma hat different from sigma. Now we check again if sigma hat is a biased estimate with Gramer-Krauer global bound. The Boxer first order gravity of L theta given S with regard to sigma is here. This is the first order gravity of L theta given S. According to equation 1122, the knowable CR of sigma hat is here, where zero denotation, zero is the zero matrix. This is a zero matrix. This implies the knowable CR sigma hat is inexistent. Hence, sigma hat is the bias estimate. Even there is no unbiased estimate of variance for normal distribution by MLE. MLE ignore the prior BDF f of theta given c because the f of theta given c is assumed to be fixed, but maximum Bose theory map method concern f of theta given c in maximization class when this integral is constant with regard to theta a variable theta hat equal is the a maximizer of f of theta given s. It's also the maximizer of this the Bose theory BDF, and also the maximizer of the roadblock of f of s given theta and f of theta given c, because this integral, the determinator is ignored. Let f of s theta given c be the zone BDF of s and theta, where theta is also random variable too, not c is the parameter in the prior BDF f of theta given c. The Nyquist function in map is also f of s theta given c. According to equation 1.23, theoretical mean and variance of s are based on the zone BDF f of s theta given c. According to equation 1.24 and 1.25, this is expectation of s, it is mean of s, and it is variance of s. Theoretical mean and variance of theta are based on f of theta given c, because the f of theta given c is function of only theta when c is constant, according to equation 1.26 and equation 1.27. Expectation of theta e theta equal is defined by equation 1.26, and variance of theta is defined by equation 1.27. And pay attention to this formula, this equation, because it's very important for estimation. In general, stochastics of theta are still based on f of theta given c given sample s at 1, s 2, s n in which on si is iid. The Nyquist function becomes specified by the equation 1.28. The Nyquist function l theta in map is predefined with observation s or sample s as follows, according to equation 1.29 and equation 1.30, where L theta is specified by equation 1.8 with observation S or equation 1.10 with sample S. Therefore, the estimate theta hat is determined according to map a follow according to equation 1.31. Good information provided by prior F of theta given C can improve quality of estimation. Essential map is an improved version of MLE. Later on, we also recognize that EM algorithm is also a variant of MLE. All of them aim to maximize the Nyquist functions. Nyquist Hessian matrix S of theta hat information matrix I theta hat and Kramer graph knowable CR theta hat CR theta hat k are extended in map with the new Nyquist function L theta here. This is the extension, where n is size of sample s at 1, s 2, s n in width on SIRID, mean and variance of the estimated theta hat width are used to measure the estimation quality are not changed, except that the zone BDF f of s theta given c is used in test. according to equation 1.32 and 1.33. As the extension format, recall that there are two criteria to check if theta hat is unbiased estimates a follow here. Whether or not the expectation of theta hat equal e to theta, and whether or not the variance of theta hat equal CR, the Kramer-Kraus null bound of theta hat. It is necessary to have an example for parameter estimation with a map given symbol S, S1, S2, Sn in with on Si, Rid, it and dimension Si, hey, following multi-normal BDF here, where mu and sigma are mean vector and covariance matrix of F of S given theta respectively, with note that theta equal mu sigma t in mu in theta mu sigma t symbol only mu distribute normal with parameter C mu 0 and sigma 0, where mu 0 and sigma 0 are theoretical mean and covariance matrix of mu. Thus, sigma is variable but not random variable for the assumption, because in practice it is necessary to estimate the sigma. It is difficult to estimate them. The second level parameter C is constant. The variable BDF f of theta given C becomes f of mu given C, which specified a follow here. Not mu 0 is the n element vector like mu, and sigma 0 is the nn matrix like sigma. Of course, sigma 0 is also invertible in symmetric. Theoretical mean and theoretical variance of S are here. Expectation of S, mean of S is equal to mu 0, and variance of S vs equal sigma. The Ngoc-Nghiu-Hood function in map is here. This is the Ngoc-Nghiu-Hood of the sum of F mu sigma and L theta. Because the normal BDF is smooth enough, from equation 1.24, the estimated theta hat, mu hat, sigma hat is a solution of the equation created by setting the first order of L theta correcting mu and sigma to be 0. The first order box of the gravity of L theta with respect to mu is here. Setting this box of gravity to be 0, we obtain where I is identity matrix and S bar is the average up on Si. The first order Boxer gravity of L theta with respect to sigma is here. Setting this Boxer gravity to be 0, we obtain we obtain the formula to calculate to estimate the sigma, the covariance matrix. But this equation is complicated to compute, because sigma is independent from the prior BDF f of mu given mu 0 and sigma 0. It is estimated by MUE as usual. Yes, this is the result estimate of from MUE method. The estimate theta hat in map here is ACMA, the one in MRE, and so it is biased. Substitute sigma hat for sigma, we obtain the estimate mu hat in map here. This is the estimate mu hat resulted from the map method, not the expectation of S bar equal mu 0 and the variance of S bar equal to sigma divided by n. Now we check if mu hat is an unbiased estimate. In fact, we have expectation of mu hat equal equal mu zero. This formula expansion is a little bit complicated, but it fits my book to understand how to derive, calculate the expectation of mu hat equal mu zero. Therefore, the estimate mu hat by us because the variable mu is not always to equal, always equal to mu zero. Now we try to check again if mu hat is unbiased estimate with grammar ground law about. The second order box of the gravity of L theta regarding mu is here. Grammar ground law about of mu hat is here. Calculate is here. Simple, we fit sigma so that sigma hat equal sigma zero equal sigma version of mu hat is calculated as follow here. V mu hat equal to n divided by n less 1 square sigma. Please get my books and tutorials on EM algorithm to understand how to describe the formula. By fixing mu hat equal sigma hat equal sigma zero equal sigma, the grammar ground law about of mu hat is rewritten as follows here. CR mu hat equal 1 divided by n less 1 sigma. Firstly, mu hat is biased estimate due to brand of mu hat different from the grammar ground know about of mu hat. In general, the estimate of mu of sigma of theta hat in MOP is affected by the prior BDF f of theta given C. Even though it is biased, it can be better than the one resulted from MLE because of the variable information in f of theta given C. For instance, if fixing sigma, the version of mu hat for MOP n divided by n less 1 square sigma is smaller, lower bounded than the one from MLE sigma divided by n. Now we go to the section 3, the introduction of EM algorithm. Now we skim through an introduction to EM algorithm. Suppose there are two spaces S and Y, in which S is the hidden space, where Y is the observed space. We do not know S, but there is a mapping from S to Y so that we can survey S by observing Y. The mapping is a mainly one function phi from S to Y, and we denote phi inverse Y is the set of S so that phi S equal Y. We also denote SY equal phi inverse Y. Let F of S given theta be the BDF of random variable S, and let SG of Y given theta be the BDF of random variable Y. Not Y is also called observation. Equation 1.34 specifies G of Y given theta as an integral of f of s given theta over phi inverse of y according to equation 1.34, where theta is a probabilistic parameter represented a column vector theta, theta 1, theta 2, theta r, in which if theta I is an particular parameter if s and y are discrete. Equation 1.34 is written as follow here. It relates the integral by the sigma, the sum. According to viewpoint of Bayes and statistics, theta is also random variable as a convention let omega be the domain of theta such that theta belongs to omega and the dimension of omega is r. For example, normal distribution has particular parameters such as mean mu and variance sigma square, And so we have theta equal mu sigma square. Note that theta can decrease into a scalar as theta equal uppercase theta equal lowercase theta. The condition will be wrapped up x given y denoted k. K of x given y theta is specified by equation 1.35. According to the DLR, s equal commutator, and the term in commutator implies that implies the existence of x and y, where x is not observed directly and x is only known by many one mapping free. In general, we only know y, f of s given theta, and k of s given y and theta, and so our purpose is to estimate theta based on such y, f of s given theta, and k of s given y theta. Like MLE approach, EM algorithm also maximizes the likelihood function to estimate theta, but the likelihood function in EM concerns y, and there are also some different aspects in EM in which will be defined later. Pioneers in EM algorithms firstly assume that f of s given theta belong to exponential family, with note that many popular distributions such as normal, multinomial, and Poisson belong to exponential family, until DLR, Nemser, Gaia, Rubin, Robose, a generality of EM algorithm in which f of s given theta distributes arbitrarily. We should concern exponential family a little bit. Exponential family refers to a set of probability distribution whose BDF have the same exponential form according to equation 1.36 here. 1.36, where BS is a function of S with E called a base measure, and OS is a vector function of S with sufficient statistics. We have some slide about in the basic concepts session. Tell about discuss about the sufficient statistics. It is very important for parameter estimation. For example, the sufficient statistics of normal distribution is that O is equal SST. Equation 1.36 expresses the canonical form of exponential family. Recall that omega is a domain of theta such that theta belongs to omega. Suppose that theta is omega is convexed. If theta is restricted only to omega, then f of s given theta specifies a Gregorian exponential family. If theta lies on curve sub manifold omega 0 of omega, then f of s given theta specifies a curve exponential family. The a of theta is a partition function for variable s, which is used for normalization. Here, this is the equation, the formula to calculate the partition function a theta. As usual, a BDF is known as a popular form, but its exponential family form, a canonical form of exponential family specified by equation 1.36 here. Look, unlike popular form, although they are the same, therefore, parameter in popular form is different from parameter in exponential family form. For example, multinormal distribution with theoretical mean V and covariance matrix sigma of random variable S, S1, S2, Sn has a BDF in popular form as follows. Here, hence the parameter in popular form is the theta equal mu sigma. Exponential family form of such BDF is here, where it is theta natural parameter. theta, theta, in, theta 1, theta 2, BS, OS, partition function A, theta. Hence, parameter in exponential family form is theta equal theta 1, theta 2. Until f of x given theta 1, theta 2 look unlike f of x given mu sigma, but they are the same. They are the same. F of x given theta 1, theta 2 equal f of x given mu and sigma. The exponential family form is used to represent all distribution belonging to exponential families. A canonical form parameter is the exponential family form is called exponential family parameter as a convention. Parameter theta mentioned in EM algorithm is often exponential family parameter if the BDF belongs to exponential family and there is no addition information. But however, for the normal distribution with the mu and sigma, and we often use the popular parameter mu sigma to estimate for estimating them instead of estimating the natural parameter theta 1 and theta 2. Table 1.1 in the left in the right. So some popular distribution belonging to exponential family along with their canonical form. In case of multivariate distribution, dimension of random variable s, s1, s2, sn, t is the n. There are many a lot of exponential BDF. But this table 1.1 show two popular distribution, multinormal distribution and multinormal distribution, because they are used. They are often used often in this research. For example, it is necessary to survey some feature of exponential family. The first order, the gravity of log of a theta partition function, the expectation of transpose OS here. This is the equal to expectation of OS transpose. The second order, the gravity of log of a of theta is here. This is the second order of the second order, the gravity of the log of the a theta, where v of OS given theta is central covariance matrix of OS. If f of s given theta follow exponential family, then k of s given y theta also follow exponential family here. Not a of theta given y is the observed partition function for observation y here. Similarly, we obtain that the first order gravity of log of a the theta given y is expectation of transpose OS based on y here. The second order gravity of log of a theta given y is here, where v OS given y theta is central covariance matrix of OS given observed y. Table 1.2 is summary of f of s given theta, g of y given theta, k of s given y theta, a of theta, the gravity, the log quark of a theta, the log double quark of a theta, a of theta given y, log of a of theta given y, and log double quark of a theta given y with exponential family. Similarly, EM algorithm is the iterative process including many iterations, in which each iteration has the expectation step E step and maximization step M step. E step aims to estimate sufficient statistics given current parameter and observe data Y. Whereas M step M to re-estimate the parameter based on such sufficient statistics by maximizing the likelihood function of S related to Y. EM algorithm is described in the next section in detail as an introduction. Not in the next session, the next presentation in detail. As an introduction, DLR gave an example for illustrating EM algorithm. This is table 1.2 summary many features of exponential family. Now we go to the example 1.1 before going to discussing the detail, the theoretical description of EM algorithm. Example 1.1, ground presents the observed data Y of 197 animals following multinomial distribution with four categories such as Y equal Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4 equal 125, 18, 20, 34. The BDF of Y is here. It's the multinomial distribution. Not probability P, Y1, P, Y2, B, P, Y3, P, Y4 in Z of Y given theta are the are here. 1 divided 2, S theta divided 4, 1 by 4, subtract theta divided by 4, 1 by 4, subtract theta divided by 4, and theta divided by 4. Repetitively as a parameter, the expectation of any sufficient statistics Yi with regard to Z of I given theta is here. Observed data Y is associated with hidden data S following multinomial distribution with five categories such as S the set of S1, S2, Sn, S3, S4, S5, where this is the constraint. Y1 is the sum of S1 and S2. Y2 equals S3. Y3 equals S4 and Y4 equals S5. The BDF of S is here. Not probabilities BS1, BS2, PS3, PS4, PS5 in the BDF of S given theta are 1 by 2 theta divided by 4, 1 by 4 subtract theta divided by 4, 1 by 4 subtract theta divided by 4 and theta by divided by 4 repeatedly as a parameter. The expectation of any sufficient statistics Si with regard to F of S given theta is here. Expectation of Sy given theta equal Sy multiplied by P Si. Due to Y1 is the sum of S1 and S2. Y2 equals S3, Y3 equals S4, Y4 equals S5. The mapping function phi between S and Y is the Y1 equals phi S1, S2 is defined by sum of S1 and S2. Therefore, Z of Y given theta is sum of F of S given theta over S1 and S2 such that S1 S2 equal Y1. According to equation 1.34, in other words, Z of Y given theta is resulted from summing up F of S given theta over on S1 and S2, S1 S2 pairs, such as 0, 1 to 5, 1, 1 to 4, 1 to until 125, 0. Then substituting 18, 20, 24, 4, 83, 84, 85, because we want equal 125 from observed Y. Brown apply EMF curriculum into determining the optimal estimate theta star not y2 equal s3, y3 equal s4, y4 equal s5 are null. And so, only sufficient statistics s1 and s2 are not unknown. Given the iteration, sufficient statistics s1 and s2 are estimated as s1t and s2t based on the current parameter theta t and g of y given theta in each step below here. S1t plus S2T equal Y1T equal the expectation of Y1 given Y and theta T. Given P, Y1 equal 1 by 2 plus theta divided by 4, which implies that Y1T equal Y1 P, Y1 equal Y1 multiplied by 1 by 2 plus theta t divided by 4. When y1 equals 124, we have s1t, s2t equals 125 multiplied by 1 by 2 s theta t divided by 4. This suggests us to select S1T equal 125 1 by 2 plus theta T divided by 4. S2T equal 125 theta T divided by 4 1 by 2 plus theta T divided by 4. You know this is the suggestion. We can select another suggestion. So that the constraint, the criteria is satisfied. The sum of S1 and S2 T is equal 125 multiplied by the 1 by 2 S theta T divided by 4. According to M-step, the next estimation theta t plus 1 is a maximizer of the Knock-Lay-Hood function of s related of y. This Knock-Lay-Hood function is here. The fourth order degeneracy of s given theta is here. Because y2 equals s3 equals 18, y3 equals s4 equals 20, y4 equals s5 equals 34, and S2 is approximated by S2T. We have the fourth order gravity of the Knock-Lay-Hood function of S. As a maximizer of log of S, F of S given theta, the next estimator theta T plus 1 is a solution of the following equation here. And so we have theta T plus 1 equal S2T at 34 divided by S2T at 72, where S2T equal 125 theta T divided by 4 divided by 1 by 2 at theta T divided by 4. For example, given the initial theta 1 equal 1.5, at the first iteration we have S2 1 equal 25 and theta 2 equal 1.6082. After 5 iterations, we get the optimal estimate theta star equal theta 4 equal theta 5 equal 1.0.6268. Table 1.3 here. List estimator of theta over 5 iterations, T1 t equal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We know that theta 1 is initialized arbitrarily and theta star equal theta 5 equal theta 6 is determined at the 5, the fifth iteration. The third column given deviation theta star and theta t, whereas the fourth column gives the greater of successive deviation. Later on, we will know that such ratio implies conversion grade. For example, at the first iteration, we have theta star subtract theta 1 equal 0.1268, and the greater theta star minus theta 2 theta star minus theta 1 equal 0.1468. There are references, and the main reference, often denote that DLR reference is here. Maximum likelihood from incomplete data via the EM algorithm of the author's Dempster, Ngai, Rubin, DLR. This is the main reference in my research. And there are also other references. Thank you for your attention. I show my deep gratitude your listening. And many thanks to all of you for giving me to the bit opportunity to present my research. And this research is the first part, the introduction part in my book tutorial on EM algorithm. And now I'm very honored and happy to answer your questions.